Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. Now, before we enter into today's presentation, I just want to give you a brief reminder of what we covered last time. Last time, we focused on the suicidal worshippers, and we revealed the mystery man who was the fourth man. And inside the suicidal worshippers, we explained the courage of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, three men who were very loyal in their worship in a suicidal dimension, to the extent that they vowed to be thrown into the fierce furnace, a burning fire, and still they survived after the fourth man appeared. And today we want to enter into yet another creative dimension inside the word of God. And today we want to focus on resisting the devil's resistance. This theme, this presentation, this topic was presented to me in 2015, and it was used as a stance, as a theme for the year of 2015. And God has asked me to reintroduce it. It was introduced to me during the breaking ground of mysteries and revelations. So today we are going to be focusing on resisting the devil's resistance. And inside resisting the devil's resistance, we want to focus on the firm and bold stance. So we are mainly going to be focusing on the bold stance, which requires you to be firm in everything that you do. Let's get into scriptures. In the book of James chapter 4, verse 7, and it reads, "Submit yourselves therefore to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you." Which is James chapter 4, verse 7. Right? After having read the scripture, which is in James chapter 4, verse 7, I'm going to get into a passage that will seemingly appear as if it is contradicting with what James has inspired in his writing. Remember very well that James was one of the three disciples alongside Peter and John the Revelator, who, whenever Jesus said something crucial, something mind-blowing in terms of information, these were the most three closest and loyal disciples to Jesus. He was there on the Transfiguration. He was there when Jesus went to pray further in the Garden of Gethsemane. And this is the same James who was later beheaded for the gospel of Jesus Christ alongside the other apostles. And he is saying, submit yourselves to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. But I want you to know something, that after having received the Holy Spirit, and when you started to resist the devil, he will not just flee away from you immediately. Even after Jesus had been tempted three times, he still resisted the temptation. And the scripture says the devil departed away from him for a while, for a season. And then he reappeared. When he reappeared, he was inside Peter's body. And Peter is saying, Master, these things must not happen to you. They must not befall you. And that was about the time when Jesus was about to get crucified. And Jesus says, get thee behind me, Lucifer. He was not referring to Peter, but what was hiding inside Peter. And James is saying, Resist the devil and he will flee. But I want you to know that the devil also has his own resistance. You can never resist the devil and then he just succumbs to defeat. And he just bows to defeat automatically. You have to reach a level where you are able not only to resist the devil, but to resist the devil's resistance. It's one thing to resist the devil. It's another thing to resist the devil's resistance. When you are now resisting the resistance of the devil, you have reached another level of resistance, which is in form of boldness. I'm going to be touching on the gospel of boldness, the courage of boldness, and the stance which I defined already, which is the firm stance, the stance that was presented in the breaking ground of mysteries and revelations in 2015 after the disconnection from the family tree structure in 2014. Let's go to the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 38, and we read a passage which is seemingly contradictory to the scripture in which James is implying on resisting or is inciting spiritually on resisting the devil. And it reads, "You have heard that it has been said of old, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. But I say unto you that you resist not evil." The evil that you are being told not to resist is hatred. Why? Because the moment you want to resist hatred, it means you also have to hate. When the scripture is saying resist not evil, it's trying to give you a spiritual prescription, a remedy that allows you to become the bigger person in spirit at the end of the day. How do you become the bigger person in spirit at the end of the day? You don't revenge. You don't live for the rest of your life carrying bitterness. So when Christ is saying resist not evil, he is not saying don't resist the devil. He's saying do not revenge evil. But he is not saying do not fight evil. There's no contradiction there. You are allowed to fight evils, to wrestle against evils, to wrestle against giants, to wrestle against all manner of demons. But you are not allowed to revenge a brother. Do not resist evil. Do not revenge evil. Why? Because you also become a custodian of that evil. But you are allowed to wrestle against evil, to fight demons, to fight the works of the kingdom of darkness. But whosoever shall smite you on the right cheek, turn to him and give him also the other side. And if any man will sue you at the courts of law, take away thy coat and let him also have your cloak also. And whosoever shall compel you to go a mile, go with him an extra mile. Give to him that is asking from you. And from whosoever borrows from you, do not turn them away or turn them down. You have heard that it has been said of old, thou shalt love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say unto you, love your enemies and bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you, and pray for them, those that despitefully use you. All these scriptures, they are not telling you or teaching you to just sit back and watch whilst the devil is bullying you. No. They are trying to teach you not to fight against any cause of man that is not evil. When you wrestle in the spirit in the prayer room, you are fighting against the evil spirits. You are fighting against the demons. You are declaring against the evils in the spirit. But when you resist the devil's resistance, you are fighting another form of resistance that is against your own resistance. And your own resistance is the resistance that is in form of the Holy Spirit. Why? Because the Holy Spirit has its own agenda. And the demons also have their own mission. Therefore, when you resist, you are standing in boldness. You are preaching a word that is not allowed to be compromised. You are preaching a word that is not allowed to be changed. You are preaching a word that is the word of eternal life. You are preaching a word that is against demonic spirit, but you are not fighting against a brother or a sister. Resist that evil. That you may be the children of your Father which is in heaven. For he makes his sun to rise on the evil and the good. Meaning that he does not discriminate. This doesn't concern Lucifer the devil and his demons. This concerns your interaction, your relationship with the people. There's some society of people that have got demons. You should be able to know who you are warring against. You should be able to know who you are at war with, who you are battling against. Is it Lucifer the devil and his demons, or your war is now the war against mankind? We have men and women that are inside prison cells. They've been locked away even for a lifetime. Why? Because they took spiritual matters into their own hands. How? Instead of addressing certain matters in the spirit, they lost temper to the level that they started fighting the war in the physical. You actually know that what is inside your husband or your wife is a demon. What is inside your brother is a demon. What is inside your mother is an evil spirit. Or what is actually operating inside your father is the devil himself. And you want to address that in the physical. And the matter ends in exchanging fists, exchanging blows. The matter ends up in stabbing each other. The matter ends in blood. Nations are fighting against nations. Why? Because none of the nations have mastered the fact that there is the evil one, which they are supposed to resist. Now they want to resist the evil in the wrong manner of way. This whole world is in conflict. Why? Because they failed also to master forgiveness. This whole world is in hatred. This whole world is in bitterness. But the problem with this world is that they don't know where this evil is coming from. They fail to admit the fact that behind every crisis that is happening under the sun, Lucifer the devil is behind the coordination of all confusion and disorder. The whole world is exploded into mayhem, into a crisis of confusion, into a war zone. Why? Because everyone wants to rule the world, and everyone wants to prove a point. Everyone wants to pump out his chest. Everyone wants to prove that he is muscular. And then the world is in flames. And whilst the world is in flames, Lucifer and his demons are sitting back, enjoying every moment. Why? Because this world has failed to know the real enemy. And the enemy keeps resisting. And the world does not want to resist the devil. It wants to resist its own. The world also has preachers that don't have boldness to preach the truth. To preach the truth as I'm doing right now. Your brother is not your enemy. Your mother is not your enemy. Your sister is not your enemy. Your friend, your neighbor, all those, they are not your enemies. Yes, they are used by demons. But you are not resisting the real evil one. The evil that is hiding behind every physical significance, every physical representation, there's a spirit. It's either the spirit of God or it's the spirit of the evil, which is led by Lucifer, the devil. So, child of God, I want you to know that you have to reach a point of knowing that every evil rebellion that is against your life, it needs to be resisted at the level of wisdom, knowing that you're fighting the devil. Don't allow your war against the devil to end up hating those that are merely custodians, or those that are innocent, those that are not even aware that the devil is at work. They should not be hate in that war. For I'll give you a mouth and wisdom which all your adversaries shall not be able to resist. Meaning that your resistance should reach a level whereby you address even the custodians of Lucifer, the vessels, which are the people, knowing that you're addressing the spirits inside of them. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that be ordained are of God. Every power that is ordained, it is a power that was tolerated or allowed by God. But there is a power, there is a force out there that was tolerated by God, which you are not supposed to let that force enter your life and destroy your life. You must reach a level whereby you live a clean and blameless life, to the level that when you enter into a warfare, the devil has nothing of his inside you. Why? Because when the devil finds something of his inside you, you won't be able to resist him. It will be his word against yours. You will be on the defensive. And when you are on the defensive, you are not able to fight back. You are not able to counter. You are not able to resist. And when the devil finds something of his inside you, he will be resisting. And you will not be able to resist his resistance. Those that are able to resist the devil and immediately flees are those that shall be found blameless. The only time that I hear of a man that was attacked by the devil, yet he was blameless, it was Job. It was because God was running a test just to prove to Lucifer. And that was not an attack, it was a persecution, which Job withstood up unto the end, and he was restored. He endured up unto the end. Most Christians are not prepared to endure. If you can't endure unto the end, it means you can't resist the devil. How do you expect to endure unto the end when you can't even resist? You just allow the devil to box you. You just allow demons to trample, to step on you. Whosoever resists the power, resists the ordinance of God. Which power? Obviously the power of God, not the power of demons. And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. Which ones? The ones that resist the power that be anointed of God. The ones that resist the power that be ordained by God. For rulers are not a terror to good works. Which rulers? Even the demonic rulers. They are not a terror to good works. What it means is that for you to resist the rulers, you must also be found in good books with Christ. You can't resist the devil's resistance when the devil has something of his inside you. I've already mentioned that. For he is a minister of God to you for good cause. But if you do that which is evil, be afraid, for he does not bear the sword in vain. meaning that he bears the sword for a reason, which has got a witness, and who witnesses that you have surely sinned. Child of God, I want to pray so that you are given the resistance, you are given the boldness. In Acts chapter 4 verse 13, now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled and took knowledge of them, and they knew that they had been with Jesus. Why? Because Jesus was bold. In this ministry of mysteries and revelation since 2015, when I introduced this theme, which is resisting the devil's resistance, I've refused to give birth in spirit through the Holy Spirit any disciple that lacks boldness. That is not the product of my word. I refuse. Any disciple that fears men of integrity or men of reputation, yet they be men of this world, is not a disciple of mysteries and revelations. A disciple of mysteries and revelations does not honor or respect anyone, yet honors those that fear God. They had seen that Peter and John had the boldness of Jesus, yet they thought they were unlearned. This is what boldness does. It makes you appear like you are not intellect in whatever you do. Those that want to measure those that are operating in boldness, they always think that they are operating out of ignorance. Yet it's not ignorance. It is the standard of boldness. And when you have the standard of boldness, you have the capability of resisting the devil's resistance. There's no way, child of God, you can resist the devil's resistance with your soft attitude, with your cowardness. I want you to receive Jesus Christ today. Receive his boldness. Resist the devil's resistance. Resist the devil, and he shall flee, in the name of Jesus.
Keep.